Now we have our next segment.
Oh, yeah.
Which is,
speaking of games,
for you video game lovers. Now, I have never played Fortnite. I will never play Fortnite.
Same here.
But if you like Fortnite, I'm not saying that to be disrespectful. I'm just saying, you know, I don't know a whole lot about it.
You know what it is about it? It's too colorful. I don't like those colorful games. Like Diablo 2 versus Diablo 3. It's like
too
it was
bright.
Gritty and dark and an environment. It was Diablo, and then
it turned into
a bubbly thing. That's
not
what Fortnite is.
Let's not bear the
me.
Lead. Fortnite players may have to pay tax on the game's virtual currency after the IRS's guidelines on V-Bucks were leaked online.
Aren't V-Bucks what you can go buy at a store? Like you go into a GameStop and buy like a V-Bucks card?
I think because of the digital currency landscape with Bitcoin and all this stuff, it's now considered currency. Digital currency is currency.
But you can pay tax on it when you buy the card, though.
Or if you earn it through playing the game.
So what? If you earn it, you have to pay the IRS?
Yep.
What?
Just like Bitcoin.
What? Some 12-year-old's playing Fortnite and gets like 100 V-Bucks. It's like the IRS sends them a letter saying you owe us 20% of that.
So I want to talk about this, but I want to talk about like loot boxes and the weird
let's talk about
physical
that.
Ramifications of the digital gaming.
Loot box is a whole nother thing, yeah.
Daily Mail says concerns are rising that millions of Fortnite players may have to pay taxes on the V-Bucks they use in the popular online game after the disclosure requirement was mentioned on the IRS website. Shortly after social media users noticed the disclosure requirement and tweeted about it, the IRS deleted the reference on Wednesday and went silent on the topic. That, say cryptocurrency experts, made things even more confusing about what the agency expects Americans to report on their 1040 forms as filing season has gotten underway. Was the reference to Fortnite virtual currency, as well as a mention of the game Roblox, which sells its players Robux to buy avatar upgrades, a mistake? Or did the agency really mean to require the reporting of game money as it does with actual cryptocurrency? This is where everything's coming
down.
You
can't buy groceries with your V-Bucks, though.
Can you transfer them to other players?
I have no idea.
Then you can.
Probably.
Then you can. And that's the thing.
That's opening up a doorway for a lot of games. So many games have that, you know, system where you pay into it to buy currency in game. It's like almost every game I know, like every free game out there is has in-game purchases.
Yep. And if that is a valuable asset that can be traded for another asset, then that's taxable.
Like the game I play, the mobile game I play, Pixel Starships, it's people are, you know, I've been playing it for like 3 years and I've known people that play for a year, play for 2 years, and then they go, I'm selling my ship. I've seen people's ships. It's a space MMO, and people sell their ships. I've seen someone sell their ship for $700-$800. It's like, dang.
You gotta pay taxes on it.
Do you?
Yes, you do. Yes. If you have a ship and you sell it in game and someone gives you $800, that's $800 income.
Yeah, that's true.
Because otherwise, imagine that you could say something like, "I didn't actually build him a birdhouse. I just drew one on, and then he gave me $800 for the drawing. I shouldn't have to pay tax on that.
Well,
no, that's labor.
Yeah, it's true.
So if you
makes sense. Okay. So if you're playing the game, it doesn't matter what game it is, and you make 1,000 virtual bucks, and you sell that 1,000 virtual bucks to your buddy, and he gives you cash.
Yes, you got to pay taxes.
Who knows about it, though?
If he gives you cash?
Yeah.
So you're advocating that would be
no, I'm not advocating for anything. No, I'm just simply asking a question. You know, like, how are they going to find out? You know, like, how do they do that?
If they find out when you tell them.
So if it's a 10-year-old that does it?
Yep.
The 10-year-old has to pay taxes?
Yes, they do.
If only they taught that in schools.
Yeah.
To do taxes.
So the only thing that's really being said is, if someone's like, how will they find out? Your argument is, well, they ask you to report it.
Right.
And then when you sign the tax form, you say, I'm being completely truthful.
Right, okay.
You know.
Yeah, that makes
sense. So it says on the form that they put out online.
Oh, I see it here, yeah.
At any time during 2019, did you receive, sell, send, exchange, or otherwise acquire any financial interest in any virtual currency?
Wow.
The definition of virtual currency in IRS guidance would still encompass these. Jerry Brito, executive director at the Coin Center, a virtual currency think tank, told CNN. Brito set off an online storm of worry and protest after posting the language of the IRS guidelines mentioning the V-Bucks, which taxpayers would have to report for the first time when answering the question, at any time did you receive, we just read it. I don't think they realized the consequences of their 1040 question. So maybe this was an accident. But I honestly, I don't think it is.
I don't think it is either.
Because in World of Warcraft, for instance, if you can buy WoW tokens.
Yeah.
For like, I think it's like $20. And then someone can go to the auction house and spend, you know, something like 180,000 gold to buy a token, which grants them a month of physical game, like I shouldn't say physical, but game time.
Game time, yeah, yeah.
Subscription. Something you'd have to work for.
Yeah, Diablo 3, when it first came out, they had a marketplace that you can straight sell any item for for not in-game currency, money, U.S. dollars.
But it's not about U.S. dollars. No,
but that's what it was.
I get it, but that's obviously taxable.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is that you can go into Warcraft right now and with gold, exchange it for valuable objects that can be exchanged in U.S. currency, which means the gold in Warcraft, I could say to you something like, hey, I'll send you I'll send you 100,000 gold if you want to order that pizza for me.
Yeah.
And you'll be like, okay.
It's a different kind of Uber Eats.
The currency has real world value.
Yeah.
It has value to people. So for the longest time, I think no one really even thought about this. When video games created secondary markets, what you're saying with Diablo, with World of Warcraft, they created literal marketplaces with actual value that people would spend hard cash and work for.
I mean, this game I play, the mobile game, it's got a marketplace. You can buy and sell, like all the items, you can sell it for more bucks. And then
what's the difference between that and selling?
There isn't a difference. You're right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Virtual or physical. It's the same thing.
I think that, like, imagine if you somebody was making, I don't know, special skate shoes, and you were like, "Ooh, I'll buy those on the marketplace."
Yeah,
like you're buying an object to help you with your hobby or your league or whatever.
Yeah,
it's the only difference is that it's digital.
True.
So now it looks like the IRS is going to come down on all of these things. How insane will that be? If at the end of the year they're like, "Did you transfer any currency?" Yes, 15 billion Warcraft gold.
Right.
What's the value of that?
That's the question. Like the 10-year-old that made $1,000 like on not US dollars, but like the virtual bucks, you know, it's like, and he still has the bucks. He spent them on in-game items. Like, how is that taxable? Like if he earned them.
Business expense?
And then,
but
he doesn't have any money. He's a 12-year-old, a 10-year-old.
Doesn't matter.
But how does he pay the government the virtual bucks? Like, here you go.
Here, that's
like, what is your account in World of Warcraft? So yes. I can give you
the answer is yes.
Virtual bucks.
The answer is yes.
That's so weird.
Like,
oh my god.
People don't realize that too. Like, especially with this is all coming about because of cryptocurrency.
So the IRS is going to have to hire somebody for each game to go around and collect the money and then physically sell it or go sell it for real money, and then
the answer is yes, but the question is, will they?
It's so weird.
Think about it this way, dude.
That seems pretty complicated.
But think about now if you have a bunch of, I don't know, cartel members saying, "We only do our deals in Fortnite V-Bucks. Otherwise, the IRS comes after us." And the IRS agent is like, "We don't want to deal with setting up an account in Fortnite, so what are we going to do? Seize their V-Bucks?" But
I know I'm laughing, but you're right. It's true.
Look at Warcraft. How many people play Warcraft? 10 million or something?
I don't know.
The numbers have been improving since the last expansion.
Nice. Okay.
But I think they've been improving. They were down from their peak, so maybe it's not 10 million.
Right on.
But that means you literally could operate your business in nothing but Warcraft gold.
I guess so.
And it inflates. So there's a problem because, you know, you can't save it. If you get 1,000 gold in a month, it's going to be worth a lot less.
Right.
So there's an incentive not to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a reason to still kind of do it because what's the IRS going to do? But now that they're adding this on the form, you can't do it.
It's so weird because all these games, like a lot of the ones they mentioned, our kids are playing. That's what blows me away. It's the kids are playing it. It's like, they need to worry about learning how to be a human.
If the IRS does not target virtual currencies, like in-game currency, then people are going to be able to make trades and exchange hard values across state lines.
It's almost like they're like, oh, now people are like, oh man, maybe we should get it done before they come down on it. It's like, and sell all our stuff, or I don't know.
There's limits to what you can do with WoW gold for sure.
Yeah.
But as long as players have value it in exchange for actual US dollars, as long as there's a way to get your money out of it in some capacity.
Yeah, yeah.
Then there's going to be an opportunity for people to use that and bypass taxes.
So it says here, reporting requirements would essentially impact the popular Fortnite, which has 250 million registered players and brought in 1.8 billion in revenue last year. So that revenue that Fortnite gets, they don't have to pay taxes on
that?
No,
they do pay taxes on that.
So the revenue they're getting from people buying V-Bucks, they're paying taxes on. So the V-Bucks have already been paid taxes on, right?
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
If I give you a dollar,
mm-hmm.
and then you give your wife a dollar,
yeah.
you pay tax on the dollar I give you.
Okay.
Or so I give you a dollar.
Yeah.
You pay income tax on that dollar. Now you've got, based on a dollar, you might have like 80 cents.
80 cents.
Then you give 80 cents to your wife.
Uh-huh.
Then she gives some. Now she has 70 cents. Every time it's transferred, it's income. So this is interesting, though, because the virtual space has become so prominent and so much value is transacted.
Yeah.
Especially when we're talking about people who Twitch stream.
Yeah, okay.
And the you know, what you might gain as an asset to help your business in a digital space,
but, you know,
that's expensive.
It kind of makes sense. It feels like they're trying to figure out how to do it correctly with the, you know, to handle it in a way that doesn't piss everyone off, I guess, you know, but it's like, you know, we have a digital economy and it's growing.
Yep.
And it's getting bigger and bigger every year, and it can grow exponentially forever because it's digital, and that's kind of great in a way.
And this is what breaks the IRS. I swear, I think this is what does it.
Yeah.
Because there's no way the IRS is going to open a Fortnite, Warcraft.
That's what they're going to have to do, though.
Fallout.
To get, like, how, you know, it's like, all right, well, for every single game out there.
They can't even ask that question. It's impossible.
Right. It's like, okay,
if I was gonna,
I made, you know, I'm in the winning, like, the top fleet in this game that I play, and we win X amount of whatever. When we win, we get X amount. So, I mean, I just use it in the game. I don't sell it. I don't consider it money, but I could buy, you know, I could do like buy the $20 card and get X
amount.
Can
you sell it though?
I bet I could.
Yep.
I haven't, but I've seen my, you know, these people that are like, I'm selling my ship, and part of the value of the ship is how much in-game currency they have. You know, if they have a lot,
this is crazy,
that
man.
Raises up the amount.
Look at this. They say the IRS on its website defines a convertible virtual currency as one that has an equivalent value in real currency or acts as a substitute for real currency.
So the fact that the $20 card, or, you know, the $20 in-app purchase is equal to this much, which isn't even that much, it feels, you know? And then, so I have X amount that, well, see, like, I don't even pay attention to what I've, like, gained and spent.
Yep.
And gained and spent.
They'll have to, like, keep a record of it.
I couldn't answer that question. I'd have to, like, go and ask the developers to
and
give me that
to,
information.
Like every other online transaction company will have to issue your, you know, 1099K or whatever of transacted currencies for the
how
year.
How much you've gained.
Yep.
And spent.
That's why I think this breaks.
I would quit playing every single game that I'm dead serious.
I would quit. No, they would eliminate the marketplaces.
They'd have to.
Yep.
Yeah, they'd have to.
And they'd have to change it to straight US dollars only. So, man, there would be no earning of credits or points or experience.
No gold.
Man.
That's yeah. Sounds like a really terrible
future. How do you get
future?
Rid of gold in World of Warcraft?
I know. Like, what?
This is crazy. Look, they say this. A virtual currency can be digitally traded between users and can be purchased for or exchanged into US dollars, euros, or other real or virtual currencies.
Exchanged into. See, I can't do that.
Yes, you can.
I can't.
You can't give it to another player?
I'd have to find somebody to sell it to them, but that's not, there's not a marketplace for that
you're splitting
in the game. But that's what it feels like it is, though.
No. Can you, if I said I'll give you $5 for your tokens, could you trade them to me?
No, there's no direct trading in this
game.
Well,
then we're not talking about
there's
that.
Actually a tax on every purchase in the game. So when you say...
But we're not talking about that then.
Well,
we're talking about in World
guess,
of Warcraft.
Yeah, I guess that's... every game is a little different, you know. So.
In Warcraft, I can give you gold.
Okay.
And you can literally walk up to me and say, hey, bro, can I get some of that gold? I'll give you $10.
Okay.
Now, if Warcraft finds out, they ban you. But it doesn't matter. The functionality is there.
Right.
Which means you're going to have to write down every time you earn gold.
There's so many... Man.
And guess what?
250... million people on Fortnite alone, 250 million people.
Wait, what? Really?
What?
Where does it say that? Oh, wow, 250 million registered Fortnite users?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Now let me ask a question.
And how many of those are under 18? Under 14?
But hold on. Think about the money being transferred between players,
mm-hmm.
bought and sold.
I don't consider it money.
It doesn't matter if you do.
I know,
but
yeah,
think about,
you're right. I got
do you. There's one thing, man, they always say. How did they get Al Capone? Did they get Al Capone on his booze smuggling murder?
Tax evasion.
Tax evasion.
Right.
Well, that's right. He could dump bodies in Bachelor's Grove all day and night, and they couldn't do nothing about it, but they got him on tax evasion.
Mm-hmm.
You think you know, good old daddy, Uncle Sam, is going to pass up an opportunity for 250 million people transacting V-Bucks?
No.
No, I think they're going to figure out a way to extract that.
Yeah.
They want some of that sweet, sweet Skrilla. And they're coming for you, Fortnite. They're making too much money. $1.8 billion? Uncle Sam's got bombs to build, brother. And they can't do it for nothing.
That's enough.
Now, here's my favorite part about this whole thing. I'm imagining, like, when it comes to the U.S. military-industrial complex, the war machine,
mm-hmm.
you have people working and paying taxes that fund the development.
Yeah.
I'm just imagining this, like, it's almost like hamsters on wheels powering, like, a giant machine. All these little kids playing Fortnite, earning V-Bucks, but then having to pay fractions to the government. The government then accrues, like, millions of V-Bucks and then sells them to people and uses that money to build weapons of mass destruction. How amazing and stupid is this world we live in?
Yeah. Yes. And
well,
yes.
I'll tell you what, man.
And yes.
Every single video game eventually devolves into a colorful rainbow meme nonsense world. Like, when most games first start, all of their costumes, all of their designs and weapons are very much in-universe.
Mm-hmm.
And then the company starts slowly rolling out skins and upgrades.
Yep.
And then eventually it's like, man, I remember when I used to play World of Warcraft back in the day, and everybody had kind of goofy outfits because you have random set pieces.
Yeah.
But they still looked like set pieces. It was like you had armor. Now I play the game and it's like there's a giant cat flying around and there's like a bumblebee guy, like a guy riding a bumblebee. People have these weird trinkets that turn them into random objects. And it's like Toontown.
Yeah.
It's like a bunch of random nonsense. And I'm like, if I wanted to watch cartoons, I'd turn on Teen Titans.
Exactly what I was talking about.
If I want to play World of Warcraft and see a knight fight a goblin,
yeah,
and like, I'm not looking for a giant guy running a bumblebee.
Yeah, I'm into like Dark Souls. If you guys know Dark Souls, it's hard. It's very difficult. It's a difficult game to play. If you're not into it, you're going to get killed. And it's the colors, the you know, everything has consequences. You tap a button, you're going to swing the sword and any enemy can kill you. Like, even the developer said, like, I want to make every single enemy like an experience. Like, I love that kind of stuff. So like this Fortnite, when I see people play Fortnite, it just looks silly. Like, they're walking up into the sky.
But I don't care. Look, if you want to play any game, you want.
No, I'm just talking about my own personal preference.
Some people play like silly cooking games.
Yeah.
Whatever, man. Do your thing. You know what I mean? It's like, I want to fight a dragon. You make a cupcake. You do you. But the IRS coming to tax my cupcake currency? Like, imagine if you play, what's that game?
Yeah.
Adventure Capitalist.
Okay.
Where the whole point of the game is to become
tap,
like
tap,
a...
Tap, 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 tap,
yeah,
tap,
you're
tap.
Just like, I'm making lemonade stands.
Well, you can't sell your
I know, but like,
money,
imagine
though.
how absurd that would be. Like, how do you define the value of any of these things? It's so nuts. Thanks for checking out this segment from the Timcast IRL podcast. We do the show every Monday through Friday at 8 p.m., sometimes an hour or two. And we do have a full live recorded version of the show that includes a lot of comments and smaller segments you probably don't see. If you want to check that out, you can watch live at 8 p.m. Monday through Friday, or become a member of this channel. And for $5 a month, you get full access to all of the recorded podcasts. Every day after the show, we make them available in the community section of this YouTube channel. So don't forget to subscribe and stick around for more segments and more shows Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. Thanks for hanging out, and we will see you all in the next show.